So our topic is that we are interested to make this screw to be gets magnetized. And in electricity chapter, recall the electricity chapter, and especially that the how we have able to make any uncharged body to gets magnet, sorry, to be get charged. Neutral body can be made charged by bringing a charged material. So we can make that the neutral body either positively charged body or negatively charged body with the help of the what kind of materials, whether we bring a negatively charged rod or a positively charged rod. So we can create induce electric charge in an uncharged body. Similarly, this material which is neutral, it's not a magnetized. You know, if I bring another piece of iron. Maybe suppose that the stapler. So there is no attraction, no attraction, no repulsion, nothing is there. Nothing, because both are not get magnetized. But there are certain techniques and method by which you can make materials get magnetized. And what is that technique that we are going to discuss here? So I want to move that point, but before moving to that, there is one more important information that I want to discuss with you. That basically in magnetism, we have divided the materials into the two parts, magnetic materials, the hard magnetic materials and soft magnetic materials. Please pay attention on this topic, children. Hard and soft magnetic materials. Questions comes in this topic. After a few days, I will share some PDF worksheets with you. Then you will find there are questions on this topic, magnetic materials. Hard and soft. So in my hand that I have two different kinds of materials. So on the right-hand side, on my right-hand hand, I will consider that this is a screw made of iron. And the stapler, basically that the shining surface I can see, and I will consider this is a made of steel. Steel, STEEL, not STEAL, okay? So hard magnetic materials, steel is an example of hard magnetic material. And what is the property of this steel? The steel material is used to make a permanent kind of magnet, permanent magnets. What do you mean by permanent magnet now, children? Permanent magnet means if you're able to make a magnetic materials permanent, so it means that for a longer and longer period of time, it can maintain or it can retain its magnetism in itself. So that is called a permanent magnet. So two hard materials are used, example is steel. They're used to make what? Permanent magnet. Questions come children on this topic. To make a permanent magnet, what kind of material is required? Hard materials, soft materials, or maybe third type of material, fourth kind of materials. The four options will be there. Then our answer is hard materials. That is, steel is used. And one more thing. To make this steel, to be get magnetized, it's a we need to put a lot of efforts. Like as you are students of grade 10, and if you're looking to get A star in IGCSE exam, so you have to put a lot of efforts. It's not easy to get A star in IGCSE. Similarly, to make this material, what material? Steel material, hard materials. If I am interested to make it a permanent magnet, I have to put a lot of efforts. The technique I'm not talking about here. But if I need to make it a permanent magnet, I have to put a lot of efforts. It will take a lot of time, a lot of efforts. But after that, once it gets magnetized, again, it will take a lot of times and a lot of efforts to make these materials to get demagnetized. Both things are there, children. You have to put a lot of efforts to make it magnetized, and you have to put a lot of efforts to make it demagnetize. Even it's become very, very difficult to make it demagnetize. On the other side, soft magnetic materials is opposite of the hard. Example is iron. Iron. Now don't consider sir, iron and steel, both are very strong. Both are the solid materials. No, here in the comparison with the steel, that iron is a soft kind of materials, and the property of iron is that you can't use iron to make as a permanent magnet, because the property of the iron in case of magnetism is that it is easily get magnetized and it easily get demagnetized. We are not going to the theory that how we can easily get magnetized and demagnetized. That is a part of the higher education, grade 11, 12, we will study. So here in the grade 10 children, piece of iron, you can easily magnetize it. Even at your home, you can easily magnetize a piece of iron, a nail, by using a proper technique that I will explain you. And easily it can lose its magnetism. So that iron is used to make temporary magnet. Temporary, you know, temporary means the temporary relations, you know, especially the temporary, that relation remains for a very short period of time. So similarly here, the temporary magnetism means that remains for a very short period of time. That is the meaning of here, soft magnetic materials. Now, the first technique, that how will you make this piece of iron to get magnetized, is this method, children. I don't have a magnet here, but I don't have. Sometimes if I move to the physics lab, then we will try to do this activity there. And see it clearly. If you make this piece of iron, that is the soft material, in the vicinity of the magnet, or to touch it or to keep it with the magnet, after a few times later, you know, this material also gets its property of magnetism. Means it will behave like a magnet, but like a very weak magnetic field. Very weak magnetic field will be there. Its strength or its power will be very weak. So that, but that is the method you can make a material, magnetic material, to get magnetized, by bringing the magnetic materials in the presence of a magnet or in the presence of a magnetic field. This is the one kind, that the influence of company, as we have seen, if I spend my more and more time with the person with having positive attitude, and those who want to be like a billionaire in their life, they are great entrepreneurs, you know, they want to earn a lot of money, they want to be a good speaker, motivational speakers. So if I spend more and more time with such kind of people, with such kind of fellowship of people, so my nature also means I also incline towards them. In the beginning, students, if you start watching the motivational videos, or maybe if you want to spend in the Bitcoins and cryptocurrencies, if you start watching the videos, and then solely that you incline toward that, you want to buy, you want to invest, okay, your intentions. And if you are wanted to be a scientist, that you have to watch the videos related to the science and to the universe. And then if you start watching, then your interest create there, and you make a career that I want to be a scientist, I want to be an engineer, like that company. And if you live in a colony, in an area where you find that the poor peoples are there, you know, children, so you are thinking, we consider ourselves that we are happy that we have a motorbike, we are very rich compared that those people, they don't have the motorbike we have. So the influence of fellowship is very important, children. The same thing happened here in the case of the magnetism also. Second method I want to discuss with you, children. The second method is very interesting method, you know. You can do, and I will encourage all of you, please try, do this activity at home, and you can do. You need to buy a cell. A battery is easily available. And even if you don't want to go to the market, just take out the battery from your wall plug, okay? And nail screw is easily available at home. You will find somewhere this, and maybe wire is required in which the current can flow, any conducting wires is required. So you need to wind the conducting wire on the nail, and you have to complete the circuit. Okay, you have to pass a current. So electricity, we already discussed these points. You need to complete a circuit. When you switch on, then the current start flowing in the wires, and after a certain interval of time. How the nail get magnetism, that we will discuss at the end of this chapter. There are explanations there. The Faraday's explain all this concept, that in the previous class, that one of the students asked, sir, how it is possible? The magnet is not there, sir. How this nail gets magnetized? This nail will get magnetized, children. Why? This explanation was given by many years back by the Faradays, by the scientists, that current carrying wire means when current pass through conductor around the conductor magnetisms induces. So around this current conductors, the yellow wires, you can see magnetic field will be there. That magnetic field will make the nail to get magnetized. That's the method, children. Don't worry, have patience. In next few classes, we will understand how this nail gets magnetized. Okay, so this is the second method that by which we can make a material gets magnetized. Let's move to the third method. Third method is also there, but that's not very interesting, not very popular. That is, place the material to be magnetized in a strong magnetic field. Okay, that is related to the first point, and hammer the material. Okay, the hammering agitates the atoms within the material and cause them to align. Okay, what happens here? If we have a magnetic materials like and placed in a magnetic field also, and we strike with the hammer, and maybe the possibility that initially if that magnetic materials is not magnetized, so the atoms, they can align themselves in a one particular order and they get magnetized. But actually that beating and hitting with the hammer is the best example for demagnetized. Means if you have a magnetic materials, means magnetic material get magnetized and you want to demagnetize it. What is the best way to demagnetize it? Start beating it with a hammer, striking with the hammer on the material. And after some, it will lose its magnetism. So now let's see, there are a few points mentioned here. Electromagnets topic we will discuss on next week, I mean on the next class. But before that, there are certain methods. Are you listening, children? Or I'm just only speaking with myself? Are you here?
Yes, sir, we're here.
Okay, good, thank you. So the methods, demagnetism, how you can demagnetize, this is another important question, children. If you are listening carefully, then you will find some questions in your exams. First method, heat it what? The material which gets magnetized and you want to demagnetize it. So if you are interested to do demagnetize, children, so it means you should be wise that you have to consider that the soft material, not hard material, because to make hard materials to be demagnetized is very, very, very difficult and challenging task. So we have to choose material, iron, piece of iron. So if iron is get magnetized, but now I want to make it demagnetized, first, heat it. Heat it means heat it. Bring in the presence of the very high temperature, that automatically after some time it will lose its magnetism. Second, first is the heat it, H-E-A-T, heat it. The second one is heat it. Okay, pronunciation, difference in the pronunciation, that the H-I-T, heat it. Now, simply hammering a magnet shakes all the molecules and disrupts their magnetic alignment. Heat it, that's like in the hammers, if we keep striking, and then you can demagnetize it. And the third one, the last one is a very important point. The last one, children. Use a coil with an alternating current passing through it. Alternating current, children. Remember, when you are interested to make a magnetism, materials to get magnetized, you need a DC current, DC cell. But when you need to demagnetize material, you need alternating current. Alternating current means, what do you mean by alternating current? Still, we have not discussed more about the AC current. In this chapter, we will discuss on about the AC in more in detail. And AC means that the alternating currents, it moves in the form of wave cycles, positive cycles is there, negative cycles is there. So for in alternating current, it has frequency 50 Hertz, means in 1 second, it becomes 50 times positive, it becomes 50 times negative. So this variation in magnetic field means magnetic field varying maximum, then it will reduce to zero. Again, it becomes maximum in the reverse direction. So when there is a variation in the magnetic field, that variation in magnetic field will cause that the magnetic materials get demagnetized. Demagnetized. Yeah. So you can do it by these activities. You can also do. Try to make materials get magnetized, then put it into fire. It will lose its magnetism. Hit with a hammer, it will lose it. But especially the third point is difficult because alternating, I won't suggest it because alternating current, you may get harm. Okay, electric shock, maybe you may get electric shock. But first and second point is easy to do at home. Okay. That's enough for the day, children. Okay. Oh, it's 1:15 also.